be all right.
What's it supposed to feel like? You've been shot more than anybody I know. I'm gonna be okay.
Wilkes.
I'll live.
You're dying, Wilkes. Are you all right?
Is that a joke?
I'm sorry. Turn. You're headed for Myanmar. The mission's not over.
What about Wilkes?
We're scrambling for a replacement. We might have a runner in Japan we could borrow, a woman named Cohen.
What's in Myanmar?
Nicolads. We used the Kalinatek data to pinpoint him at the Chinese embassy in Rangoon.
Chinese support for the Georgians?
The political situation isn't good. If they are backing Nicolads, you better find rock-solid proof. I don't want to go into World War III without a good reason. You've got some time before you reach Rangoon. You want me to patch a secure phone line so you can talk to Sarah?
No.
Disaster was narrowly averted at the Pickett Gap Water Treatment Plant in Tennessee. Plant management attribute the malfunction to a remote viral attack, possibly the latest act of terror in the Georgian information crisis. Still have no leads in the search for Kumbain Nicolads. NATO and charity groups working in Azerbaijan continue to uncover the corpses left from what was only the beginning of the Georgian president's campaign of high-tech terror. If not for the swift intervention of plant employees, hundreds or even thousands could have become life-threateningly ill from contaminated water.
They say we're safe and all right, but then they tell us to boil our water.
Seeing the disaster averted at Pickett Gap, a possible turning point in the Georgian information crisis, marking the first time American authorities were able to recognize and overcome one of Nicolads' acts of terror. Described early diplomatic negotiations with China a mixture of silence and antagonism. The Chinese claimed that the U.S. are using suspicions of Georgian support as an unfounded excuse to inspect Chinese weapon stores, and have so far refused cooperation. If possible, lending an even greater urgency to the search for Kumbain Nicolads.
Chinese Embassy, Yangon, Myanmar, November 11th, 2004, 2013 hours. Find the Georgian-Chinese connection. Using intelligence gleaned from the Pickett Gap program, Third Echelon has traced communications between Nicolads and the Chinese Embassy to Myanmar. Any suspected connection between Nicolads and the People's Republic of China must be proven before any action can be taken. Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to more Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell in first-person perspective. Now, there's a massive break between the previous two levels. I don't know if you've noticed or not, but if you take a close look at the dates, the previous mission, Kalinatek, it ended on the 1st of November. This mission is taking place on the 11th of November. And if you actually took a look at the cinematics in, you know, between the levels, you notice that they were showing Sam, you know, kneeling over a dying Wilson Wilkes Jr. Over Russian airspace on the 9th of November. Now, it can't exactly be that, you know, Wilkes died, Wilkes like took 8 entire days to die, and the plane, you know, just magically decided to take a trip to Russia all the way from, you know, the USA just to give Wilkes a fitting funeral. But yeah, I mean, it's just one of the examples of how they just removed a very big part of the plot here without bothering to make the necessary arrangements to make sure that the cut is in order so that it goes smoothly. And yeah, while it is sad, well, it is what it is. You can't really help it, because I mean, Ubisoft Montreal was, or do they call it Montreal? I don't know, anyway, my friend sucks. Anyway, yeah, so Ubisoft Montreal just decided to, you know, remove the level entirely, but Ubisoft Shanghai, the company which was, or rather, you know, the branch which was assigned the PS2 version of the same game actually went ahead and, you know, just added that level to the game anyway. And Montreal was like, yeah, okay, it's fine, cool, no need to take it out if you guys have already made it. We're just gonna cancel this level from our end. And yeah, they never really bothered to change the cinematics or the story. I mean, in this level itself, you'll find a lot of communications and intercepted data which will point towards the entire nuclear power plant thing having actually had taken place, which again breaks the continuity of the tale, but I have dragged this on for long enough as is. Without further ado, let's go and do this.
Your contact is in place. Our man in Burma or Myanmar.
Whatever. Where do I find him?
A rooftop a few blocks from the embassy. Says he's under a large red sign. You respond to the phrase, a bright cold day in April. We've updated your opsat. To be clear, if you kill anybody, this mission's over. You slip up on this one.
I'll find a fallout shelter and learn some prayers.
I'm glad you understand. Be good.
Okay, pal. We're here. This is as close as we can safely get in a vehicle. I can't overemphasize how sensitive this mission is. We can't have a single casualty.
Shouldn't be a problem.
Lambert will give you a position for our contact as you get closer. He's had to stay mobile to avoid detection.
I'll find you when the job's done.
Good luck. And my condolences for Lieutenant Wilkes. I understand he was a good man.
I'll find you when the job's done.
I do hope we'll get along. Your profile at the Ford said you wouldn't have trouble working with a woman.
It doesn't worry me. Don't bring up Wilkes again.
Sure. Sure. Good luck.
Sam's pretty sore about it, and this woman got spooked. I mean, it's sort of serious. You know it's serious when Sam refuses to talk to his daughter because he's just processing whatever happened, and he doesn't even get a break to do that. But yeah, hopefully for their sake, he and Cohen will get along pretty well. At any rate, just to clarify things, they do in fact mention that the data from the Kalinatek servers or the Kalinatek building actually points to the Chinese embassy. But then again, there are the end screen and as well as the Russian airspace scene during the cinematic. They never really bothered to, you know, edit that out or even like cut it out entirely. So yeah, I mean, that sort of, here I'm trying to climb this pipe, which I always do, and I never can, you know, like, they don't want you to climb this pipe, because if you do, apparently it would make the game too easy, or maybe a little difficult, because you need to head to the left here. In either case, yeah, so they do try to tie up that one loose end, but they end up doing a pretty sloppy job of it, because they haven't taken care of the rest of the data sets, or, you know, at least the end screen there, because it's not just this mission, it's this mission plus Abattoir, where you'll be able to see how they, you know, keep bringing up the nuclear power plant incident and how Mars was killed. This area is pretty easy. I mean, there's like a shadow which will take you over to the other end. And the thing is, unless you're using the night vision, it looks like the other end is too well lit for Sam to be. So, unless you're using night vision, it looks like the other end is too well lit for Sam to be in. But that is not the case. As you can see, it's like perfectly in the shadows. Now, one of the things that is that I am missing at this part right here is the fact that I can't use the third person peek, but at least I can still, you know, sort of shimmy along whatever cover, meager cover I have, just to check up on the status of my enemies. This next section, I also tried to do it a little differently than I normally do, and a few things I found easier, a few things I made easier for myself by taking out some lights, but I don't know why, but maybe it's all the repetition that I put into this game, but it just, the sneaking aspect just feels much easier now. So yeah, like, for instance, this section right here, I mean, I just decided to take out the light altogether to help ease things along. And I do believe that they did want you to do stuff like that to make the game easier for yourself. Now, another thing that I notice about Shanghai is that, sorry, Myanmar, is that it looks like a beautiful place. So see, this is one of the problems you have with this mod, and it's that you don't really know when you are hanging onto something. I just put my legs up there because I felt like I was a little too in the light at that point, just to be safe. But at any rate, the backdrops of this level, they look really pretty under the night vision goggles, but as soon as you take them off, yeah, they look pretty horrid. So probably could have done a better job with them, but then again, I doubt a lot of people actually pay much attention to it, so I guess it gets the job done anyway. I mean, look at those monstrous trees, they look like they're like, what, 20-30 stories high? Yeah, you can't take those lights out, I don't know why. If it was Chaos Theory, you could have, but not in this game. And you can actually jump over to the other side. It's just more difficult to do in the third person than it is in the first person. And I mean, even the next section, I found it a little difficult in the third person, but I mean, seeing myself pull it off in the first person, it seems so easy. And judging by the conversation, it sounds like they shot somebody, you know, for being outside of their homes during the curfew. I wonder if this is what Myanmar is typically like, and whether these are actually Burmese soldiers, or you know, these are Chinese soldiers. But at any rate, I'm curious because see, Myanmar as a country, it has always had its own political struggles and civil wars and coup d'etats, and sometimes it like tosses an iron curtain around itself, and sometimes it's like, you know, a pretty standard touristy place to be in. So I'm actually genuinely curious whether there is such a thing as a night curfew in Myanmar. During maritime at that, I'm pretty sure there would be during wartime, but I don't know about whether that's a thing during the maritime. So yeah, this section is also pretty easy. As soon as this guy turns around, you just head down into the gutter. Into the sewers. And I don't know why I decided to, you know, spend so much time here doing nothing, but I did. I guess I was explaining something. This section just requires you to wait things out, and that's it. I mean, you still do need to play it aggressively, play the stealth little aggressively, but it look how pretty that looks, the red light there. Anyway, this section just, you know, requires you to wait things out and not rush. Like, move when the opportunity presents itself, but don't linger around for longer than necessary. And look at me exploiting the third person, sorry, the first the bug in the first person mod. You can like literally peek through objects like this. It was probably built into the game as a means of ensuring that nothing obstructs the player's view, but yeah, it doesn't exactly work out all that well. Then again, I mean, this mod is not an official one, it's just, you know, sort of like a hack that somebody's using. So I guess, you know, this is something that you can expect, that you should be expecting at least. Excuse me, need to cut that out. So yeah, so I saw that man, I saw that, you know, ladder up there, and I was sort of wondering if you could hide up there if required, because I think there is one level in Pandora Tomorrow where I moved back there, because you can see a guy, you know, coming towards your direction, coming towards you at this point, and I'm just gonna wait it out until he, you know, starts heading back before making a move. At any rate, there is a level in Pandora Tomorrow where you're in the sewers as well, and I have tried, like, every single time I play that level, I always get confused as to where the exit is. It's one of those ladder thingies up in the ceiling, but yeah, it's very difficult to notice unless, you know, you know where to look.
Of course we can hurt them, but America has spread too far. We could never crush all the cells.
Not this again.
What? Hang's got this idea about fast food restaurants and amusement parks.
They are the American version of terrorist cells.
You know, small, widely scattered, independent, high-tech, coordinated propaganda centers.
You're clever.
You will see. We can kill their soldiers and flatten their capitals, but we will never beat their hamburger stands.
This is why I hate being on patrol with Tang.
And he's actually not wrong. I'm not that educated when it comes to the social studies, but I do believe that there is this notion called mockocracy, which essentially, since, you know, America is so big on democracy and peddles it all the time, and it also has a tendency of commercializing literally everything, there's this thing called mockocracy, which is sort of a satire on that entire aspect, that they're actually commercializing the political philosophical idea of democracy as well. And yeah, I mean, he's not wrong. That is something which a lot of social studies students actually study about, that it could possibly be a thing. Because, I mean, no matter where you go in the globe, you will see fast food joints, and yeah, you could call it a means of business, but then again, I personally would also say that that is, you know, a way for Western culture, at least, to propagate into other countries, because as time goes by, of course, if you're living in the US, it does not change at all for you. Things are the same as they have always been, but like, even if you go to some remote East Asian country, or, you know, like a remote African country, you'll notice how literally everything, you know, they have started adopting Western culture. Like, it all started with Western clothing, and, you know, that is, of course, can be said that that's a remainder from the time when...
It's a bright, cold day in April.
Good. But take this, okay?
That was an empty hand.
You're late, but you're here. Okay.
What did you give me?
We need to do this quickly.
Go ahead.
That map will show you the general's office in the courtyard.
I thought it was the ambassador's office.
It was, but some Chinese general has been using it. You can see for yourself. You get into the embassy grounds through the rear service entrance.
Is there a gate?
Yes, but a delivery truck will be pulling through shortly. You can sneak in past the truck, no problem. But you only have one chance at it.
Solid work.
I'm very good at my job.
Well, okay. At least he knows he's very good at his job. But yeah, like I was saying, a lot of it can be attributed to back when the Europeans were busy colonizing the world. But like, even beyond that, the world is slowly adopting Western cultures, and I don't know whether to call it, you know, the influence of these American, you know, fast food joints and, like, just American media in general, or maybe it's more about a process of globalization, because even if you look in the West, there are, you know, Japan and Korea are leaving their impact there through popular culture. So I'm guessing it's just the influence of, you know, new avenues of information technology, just, you know, broadening people's horizons and giving them just more information and culture to adopt if they want to. I mean, you could look at it that way as well, but then again, it's like a completely, you know, different form of study, which I'm not really an expert on. At any rate, that is not what this video is about, and I should probably focus on this instead. So yeah, I made a cut there because I was indecisive about where to hide the body. There will be another cut here because I just had to unnecessarily shoot that light out when I didn't even need to follow that, you know, go up there. I mean, this is a path you can take which, you know, leads you up there. You don't need to take it. It's completely optional. You can just follow the route. But I just had to take the light out because, well, I was having too much fun. And this guy spent 2 entire minutes investigating it, and I still ended up going up the stairs instead of just following this guy and sitting through shadows, which I could have very safely done without any repercussions, and it would have been less time consuming and a more straightforward path. At any rate, we all make mistakes. This is one of those, like, this is one of the mistakes which I made, and well, it is what it is, I guess. Nothing more to it. He also comes up here to investigate, by the way. I cut there because it took me a lot of tries to get onto the scaffolding of the ladder. Just one of the few things which makes it difficult for you to pull off the first person mod. I love how the specific hallway looks, you know. So detailed with all the lighting. It has got a very rugged, dilapidated look to it. Like a, you know, gambler's den. Sort of. Or maybe a thief's den, if you will. But yeah, if you want to take this path, you need to take that guy out. This guy who's patrolling right now. And your timing needs to be pretty good. Otherwise, you can risk losing him. Or getting detected. At any rate, there's no point in coming up here unless you're gonna take the zipline. Which is, again, completely optional because we could have just taken the path downstairs. Which I realized after playing, while, you know, I get over to the other end using the zipline, and then I realize that, oh yeah, I didn't need to take that huge detour, but at least it gives us this data stick. You guys can go ahead and pause if you want to read this. It basically talks about how Fisher, or rather, you know, what they assume are 10 to 80 American soldiers who attacked the Nadesa power plant, and how Philippe Mas has been killed. They could have, you know, worked a little better as far as the storytelling goes. The continuity of the tale does require a little bit of work, but it was the first game. They were still getting a grasp on what a stealth game is, so I won't really fault them for this. In the end, it is...
Truck's going to be your only chance to get inside the embassy. Don't blow it.
Is there something going on I don't know about?
All you need to know is this. If you do find Nikolaj in there, be ready to scramble. One wrong step could mean war. If anybody in the embassy triggers an alarm, we're pulling you out. The mission's over.
Yeah, so I won't exactly fault them for that. As far as the stealth part of the game goes, it's good enough.
Something more. I've got an armed hostile!
So this guy got knocked out. He's like out cold right now, sleeping, shocked into a state of unconsciousness, and he still managed to get those last few words out. I mean, needless to say, this is just one of the things which Chaos Theory really improved upon, but yeah, again, I won't fault them for these minor bugs, because in the end it is a minor bug. It's not like, you know, the alarm actually went through and other people got to, you know, got alerted and started searching for me.
Hello.
Hey, it's me again.
May I see your papers?
This is the seventh time tonight. Can we give the papers a rest?
This protocol comes directly from Feirong. Let me see your ID. Thank you. Authorization should only take a minute.
The driver, the voice actor of the driver sort of reminds me of the doctor turned comedian who was the villain in The Hangover.
Very good.
I forgot his name.
You're cleared.
Kevin Hay, is it? I forgot. I completely forgot his name. And I was almost about to get run over by that truck, but yeah. And here's the difficult part. I do not know the solution to this. I honestly do not know the solution to this, because every single time that I play it, I always just have to take that dog out. There's just no way around it for me. This time around I tried a few more tricks, tried playing it a little, you know, in a more freestyle fashion, if you will. Nothing worked out. So yeah, right now I'm heading over to the bridge when the doggy detects my scent. And I'm just gonna jump off the bridge and, you know, circle in the water a few times, hoping that the doggy will not be able to come get me. But as it turns out, that is not the case. The doggy has a very sharp nose, and it follows you, no matter where you are. Initially, I thought that the dog, maybe, you know, continues to come close to. Yeah, it turns out that the dog actually keeps coming close to your current location. When I had initially thought that the dog actually follows your trail, because that's how I lost one of the dogs in Georgian Presidential Palace.
Give me three more days. The devices can be armed in one and placed in the next. Of course they are, but you know the details. We need to strike together, or we may as well not strike at all.
This guy Loki makes sense.
Listen to me, because you will reveal us. That's ridiculous. How could they listen? That's paranoia, but fine. No, fine. We will have a safe conversation. I will call you back from my car.
Yeah, I mean, that guy...
Good Lord, Fisher. That's General Kong Ferong.
Lord? Who's that?
He was the chairman of China's Central Military Commission until 01. Very high PLA muckamuck.
A Chinese general talking to Nikolaj isn't good news.
Whatever he's going to say when that conversation resumes just became our highest priority. Stay with him. Time to get invisible. Anyone so much as sees you when the mission's over.
I wonder if using the, you know, distraction cam would work on the dog. And I don't know why he just took, you know, an entire turn there. Like, he walked around in a big circle before heading to the car. Just one of the glitches that these older games had, the pathfinding glitches.
Not the only ones I'm worried about eavesdropping. They are just the most skippable. Of course. How many times will the signal be rerouted? You also believe your colder peninsula base untraceable. I understand the psychology of war. Yes, yes. I've attended many executions. but never American. Hold on a second. Driver, how far away is Mukobo Meet?
10 minutes, maybe more. But we'll have to stand a police check along the way.
No, it's not worth the trouble. I will just watch the broadcast like everyone else. Yes, too true. You are a wicked man, Mr. Nicolas. I hope your performance goes well. Take care.
They're going to execute the soldiers.
Sounds like it.
You've got to stop them. Rendezvous with Cohen. I'll forward her the coordinates for Mook.
Mook Zobo.
Right.
Auspicious hunting ground.
Damn straight. The time for subtlety is past. I need to get this to the Joint Chiefs. See if this means...
Yeah, he says the time for subtlety has passed, but... there are actually alarms in the next mission. Despite, you know, how they can tell in the first 5 minutes that American troops have invaded, there is an alarm system in the next game, and 5 alarms means mission over. So, yeah. Time for subtlety has passed my ass. So... this area isn't as difficult as I make it seem. I sometimes tend to forget that these guards, they can't really see that far. So, yeah, you're clear to go pretty much wherever you want to go through. And I love how conveniently, you know, the barbed wire on top of the fence that sort of, you know, conveniently just cut off right where there's a pipe for you to climb up from. And I could see Sam's teeth again. How nice. And that's it for this mission. I sort of wanted to go check what's back there, but decided against it. Since it's the end of the mission anyway. But let's head over into the debriefing. Next.
Hop in the back. We gotta go. Grab hold of something.
Chinese Embassy, Yangon, Myanmar, November 11, 2004, 22:35 hours. Intelligence gathered at the embassy links Nicoladze to Kong Feirong, a prominent general in the People's Liberation Army of China. Additional information reveals that captured American soldiers will be executed on Nicoladze's order during a webcast from Mukzobo Meats, a nearby slaughterhouse, in a few short hours. So basically, Sam's in a hurry. He just, you know, intercepted some communications between this general and, you know, the Georgian president. And, turns out that China may be involved. Right now we need to figure out to what extent they're involved, and first and foremost to stop the execution of the American soldiers. That being said, this mission was a little difficult for me, primarily because how you need to sneak around, and as you probably saw, I took a few liberties here and there by knocking some people out, which I typically would not have done. But just to make things easier for me with the first person mod, I went ahead and did that. Anyway, at any rate, this mod is meant to make the experience more akin to a shooter instead of a hardcore stealth game. But anyway, let's go ahead and save some American soldiers from Mukzobo Meats, from being executed in Mukzobo Meats. We'll cover that in the next video. And until then, take care. Farewell, fellow things.